Ruby.
And welcome back to So in the Know. Well, we've officially made it to the end of summer, but this Labor Day weekend doesn't have to be a bummer. There are tons of fun things happening in our area. Here's what's going on this week.
Nice rhyme. That's pretty good.
Thank you.
Enjoy a very special First Friday Flea Market at Space September 3rd and 4th. Space is a 2,000 plus square foot warehouse in downtown Lancaster, which specializes in mid-century modern furniture, lighting, glassware, pottery, art, and vintage home decor items. In addition, they have a large selection of vinyl and video games. This market promises to be the most epic to date, with tons and tons of vintage furniture and smalls all priced to sell. In addition, a few choice vendors will be joining them as well. They will have an incredible selection and the deals are legit. The flea market takes place September 3rd from 11 to 9 and September 4th from 11 to 4 and will be held in their garage. While you're downtown, be sure to check out the other galleries and shops that'll be open for First Friday fun.
This Labor Day weekend is also the 43rd annual Longs Park Arts Festival. Did you know that the first art festival in Longs Park was held July 4th, 1976 and was presented by the Lancaster County Bicentennial Committee? The success of the event drew the attention of Long Park's Amphitheater Foundation leadership, who were looking for a new funding source for the amphitheater. A partnership was struck with the twin goals of creating a quality art festival in Lancaster while raising funds for the foundation and its cultural initiatives like the beloved Summer Music Series. The first Labor Day show in 1979 was held in conjunction with LPAF's annual Day of Music, featuring 87 artists and craftspeople. The Art Festival now welcomes thousands of visitors each year and hosts 200 exhibitors who are chosen through a competitive jury process. Tickets to the festival are on sale now.
The borough of East Petersburg proudly announces the return of the beloved East Petersburg Blues Festival on Saturday, September 4th. After a one-year hiatus due to the pandemic, the festival celebrates its 10th anniversary 11 years after it began. The free, family-friendly event begins at 2 p.m. and continues until 7. It will feature five outstanding acts from the Delaware Valley, covering a broad cross-section of blues music mixed with rock, soul, Americana, jazz, funk, and pop influences. Blues Time, Laura Cheadle, Greg Sober Band, Deborah Devi, and Sweet Lita will all be performing this year. Originally a grassroots event with bands literally playing on flatbed trucks and bringing their own amps, there have been great improvements over the years. The construction of a beautiful amphitheater and installation of a professional sound system have been added to the East Petersburg Community Park where the annual event is held. Food trucks will also be on site this year.
The African American Cultural Alliance of Lancaster is hosting an African American Cultural Music Festival. The event will feature speakers, musicians, artists, poets, and craftspeople. The purpose of the African American Cultural Music Festival is to offer the community of Lancaster County and beyond a unique blend of African and African American art, culture, and history. Therefore, serving as a conduit for promoting and perpetuating the art, culture, and history of African Americans and African people for the benefit of all residents and tourists to the area. It exists to support the culturally rich and diverse community by ensuring all events are inclusive to the entire community. It will take place Saturday, September 4th at 5 p.m. at Brightside Baptist Church and feature Grammy Award-winning artist Eric Bellinger and Grammy Award-winning gospel artist Leandria Johnson. You can get tickets to the festival on Eventbrite.
Man, there's so much happening this Labor Day weekend.
I know.
It's going to be a blast.
Our nonprofit spotlight this week is on Treasures Market. Treasures is a nonprofit benefit corporation retail organization that sells significantly discounted brand-named groceries, furniture, clothing, and general merchandise by offering a wide selection of closeout and donated products. Treasures strives to improve the lives of those in the community by distributing surplus funds to other nonprofit organizations that assist those in need. Treasures also offers a variety of career training and employment opportunities in the community they serve, with an emphasis on individuals with disabilities and those facing long-term unemployment and homelessness, all the while keeping unwanted and unneeded items out of the waste stream. Treasures Markets accepts donations such as furniture, household goods, and clothing at their warehouse. You can also volunteer both in-store and at their warehouse for a hands-on way to make a real impact in our community. They welcome both individual volunteers and groups of up to 15 people, and their great volunteer opportunities can fit most schedules for you and your organizations.
Well, that does it for this week's episode of So in the Know. As always, if you have an event you'd like us to share, make sure to shoot us a message on Facebook and follow us on social media at So Good Lancaster. We look forward to keeping you
So in the Know.
So in the Know is brought to you by The Candy Factory, a co-working and social club in Lancaster, PA. Find out more at coworkinginlancaster.com.